Now, you might wonder how he had the time to take on so many different businesses. Well, for one, he had his pilot's license. One of the memories that the family was sharing with us earlier today was that he actually built his first aircraft. And on the side, he wrote experimental on the side of it as well, giving everybody fair warning. And Pat was not willing to ride in that aircraft. He logged 19,000 hours in the air, and he found it a much more efficient way to get across the state to conduct his business and get things done. One day I remember Beth, who works for me, and I were standing at an airport, and we saw a man land a plane, climb out, and come walking across the tarmac, and I said, I wonder who that is, he's all alone. And she said, well, that's Governor Farrar. And that was him.
I remember one meeting like that. It was in Milwaukee. And during the course of the meeting, I got up one morning to go for a walk, trying to get my exercise. And I saw Governor Farrar running. And then later, the meeting was over, and we were at the airport, and the state plane was there to take me home. And Ron Houck, the chief pilot, said, you know, we really need to wait because we've got heavy weather here. It was raining and the winds were pretty heavy gusts. And so I said, well, you're the boss, safety first, we're gonna wait. About a minute later, a small plane took off. No rough weather was gonna delay Frank Farrar. There he went to visit a bank in Illinois. Governor Farrar had grit. You can't be a marathoner without grit. Beyond his grit, though, no one loved life more than Frank Farrar. And no one lived life more actively than he.